All right, we're back for one more. I'm trying to get rid of this chat. Here we go, replace it with this one. We win the die roll and we've got a pretty sweet one. We could turn one signet, but that doesn't really lead to anything turn two. It doesn't lead to Gilded Lotus, so we might as well wait on the Chrome Locks, get a better idea of what to imprint, maybe take advantage of the storm of it. Last match was definitely an epic one, I have to say. Sylvan Caryatid. I mean, again, we could Chrome Mox and play two things. That feels worth doing now because otherwise we won't have the mana to Gilded Lotus next turn. So we can throw away the regrowth. Have to be a bit more careful this game with what we have, as we're not getting it back. Bang, pass the turn. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Well, that was certainly explosive. We're up against the red deck. We could play a Gilded Lotus or an Oracle. I'm gonna play the Gilded Lotus. I have a feeling the Oracle is just gonna get burned out. Try to set up a situation where we can get more value out of it, maybe. All right, well, nothing from the opponent so far. Sword of Fire and Ice. Okay, no creatures though. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I guess we can play the Oracle and the Palancron. And we've really got nothing too much going on, but we'll have an opportunity of top decking just about anything and going nutsos, like Sphinx's Revelation, for instance. Demonic Tutor to find Sphinx's Revelation. Although it looks like we've just got islands coming. Was there a way to not play a land, so we could have played both off the top? I didn't see it. We could have played the Oracle only. Go for the throat, so there goes our Palancron. At least the opponent has nothing. That, so we don't need to worry about the sword just yet. Demonic Tutor, yes, please. Likely targets are Wheel of Fortune and Sphinx's Revelation. Sphinx's Revelation being the big one, because why give the opponent a new hand? Although they've got things to do with their mana anyways, so Wheel of Fortune probably be totally fine. Thundermaw. With that, I'm into the Sphinx's Revelation, most likely, because of the life gain. Play Demonic. We have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we could play it for 5 and gain 5. That seems pretty good to me. I tapped the mana wrong, so we might need to take a pain. 3, 4, f no, never mind. We have the Sphinx. We have the Caryatid, so we can do it for 6 also. I was thinking of waiting on the Sphinx's Revelation, but we haven't played a land this turn, and I want to take advantage of the Oracle, so why don't we just play this turn? Blue. Yeah, we're not even close to needing to take damage. I don't know what I was thinking. Control Z. Signets are the hardest things to operate. Sphinx's Revelation for 6. Could have Wheel of Fortune for 7, but what's the storm count? It's at 2. Unfortunately, we cannot mana drain. However, this following turn, we could play Mirari's Wake. The thing about Wheel of Fortune is losing the brain freeze. We have used our regrowth, so It's a bit awkward, really. I didn't force the will that. Probably should have. Becoming a question of how we're gonna win. Thinking about this brain freeze. Maybe balance. Balance is not really getting us through both those things. What definitely is a time walk. Let's go three. Let's tap all of our artifact mana for Amurari's Wake. Yeah, Force of Will would have been really smart. That was really bad by me to not do that. Ooh, Treachery is the best card we can draw by a million miles. So hopefully we hit that. Harmonize. Come on, Treachery. Compulsive Research. Feels worth playing. Feels worth playing because we're really trying. I mean, Garrick's a good one too. It's a lot of blue. But just trying to hit a Treachery for the win and a Time Walk. Yeah, so this will do nicely. We need to discard one land or two cards. Can play an island, play Treachery. I think we have enough to. Do we have enough to mill or close to enough to mill? We can play Treachery here, I think so. The question is whether we're going to discard an island or the Carpoolsen Forest to play Wheel of Fortune. We should have enough blue, right? We have a blue floating. We'd have to take a pain, but otherwise we're gonna have. Taking a pain is. One pain is fine. Otherwise, we're gonna have no access to Wheel of Fortune. I'm not exactly sure whether we need it or not, but it would be nice. One, we are gonna have to take pain, but whatever. Play Treachery on this. Untap five lands. Oh, the opponent can sacrifice it. I hadn't considered it. Did not sacrifice it, thank God. We still had the mana to time walk, so it wasn't over, but that was pretty loose by me and the opponent. One, two, three, four, five. So we can play like five. We need six, seven. We can play balance and mana drain. First, let's just play Time Walk because. Oh, we can Brain Freeze into Wheel of Fortune, so that's a thing. Five. Do we want to balance? We'd have to sacrifice some lands, but it's just a thing to occupy our mana. We can just play Brain Freeze into Wheel of Fortune right now. 18, and then pass the turn. Ideally, we play one more spell first. So I guess balance is fine to play. Blue, green, black, play balance. Just for storm, really. Choose six lands to keep. Two, three, four, five, six. Is this Carpoolsen Forest selected or not? It needs to be to win. Having a hard time telling what's going on. Four remaining? God, I might lose because I can't figure out how balance is working. Four remaining? Choose lands to keep. Three remaining? So what does it mean to be selected? Two remaining? Is this selected or not? One remaining? Choose a creature to keep. Keep this one. Well, we have white mana anyway, so. Or we have the Sylvan Caryatid anyways for mana, so. That was super confusing, though. Okay, mill the opponent for a bunch. Then cast Wheel of Fortune. So we did get to Storm combo, finally. Didn't get infinite mana, but. Infinite mana, it sounds cool, but on Magic Online. isn't actually that cool because it's not infinite. It's as much infinite as you have the patience to make. So it's just a lot, or sometimes not that much. You can't say, I go infinite, so booyah. Wheel of Fortune. Bam, bazinga. Force of will and response. No. See, let's take a look at the opponent's deck. Terminate, Skin Render, Chandra's Phoenix, Zealous Conscripts, Necrotal, Goblin Guide. Yeah, this is a scary deck. We're probably pretty lucky the opponent had nothing early that game. One card we want for sure in here is Kitchen Finks. Card that we can cut is Force of Will. Like, that's the best it ever would have been, and it got stranded in hand. And rightly so, because I might have exiled a Brain Freeze, and then we wouldn't have been able to win. So, let's just run it at like that.